Okay, like I said, in N1, there are several different kinds of quadrilaterals. We have trapezoid, which is what we covered in N1. We have
Then there are parallelograms. Let me do that a different color.
Parallelograms. There are special parallelograms, which are rectangle, rhombus, and square. Then we have a kite. And a special trapezoid is an isosceles trapezoid. I just basically copied and pasted this information here. I probably should have done a better job and put them kind of in order. I don't know why they told you what a quadrilateral was here, but let's go ahead and talk about it. So a quadrilateral is a polygon with four sides. Basically, that's all you need to know about a quadrilateral. Then we talked about trapezoids. A trapezoid is a quadrilateral with one pair of parallel sides. And a special trapezoid is an isosceles trapezoid. It is a quadrilateral with one pair of parallel sides, hence a trapezoid. And these are called bases. And one pair of congruent non-parallel sides called legs. We'll talk about that whenever it is appropriate. Then we have parallelograms. A parallelogram is when you have two pairs of parallel sides and they are going to be congruent. And whenever that happens, you could have a rectangle where all of the angles are 90 degrees. Or you could have a rhombus where all the sides are equal. Or you can have a square where all the angles are 90 degrees and all the sides are equal. So a square is a rectangle and a rhombus put together. And then you can have a kite. You have two pairs of congruent sides, but those sides that are congruent are adjacent to each other, not opposite. I know I went really, really quickly, but everything that I just talked about is in this diagram. Okay, and we know a trapezoid is that where these are parallel to each other right there. Those are two arrows that you just can't kind of see. All right, so everything in this is a quadrilateral. So if you have a kite, you have a quadrilateral. Trapezoid, you have a quadrilateral. Parallelogram, you have a quadrilateral. Okay? So every parallelogram is a quadrilateral, but not every quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Every parallelogram is in this box. A trapezoid is in a box of its own. So every quadrilateral is not a parallelogram. It could be a trapezoid or it could be a kite. Okay, let's erase this. There we go. Now, for a parallelogram, we have special parallelograms, rectangles, rhombi, and squares. Every rectangle is a parallelogram, but not every parallelogram is a rectangle. A parallelogram could just be a parallelogram with nothing special going on with it, or it could be a rhombus, or it could be a square. So look at this and kind of see where things are happening. A square is a rectangle and a square is a rhombus. So every square is a rectangle and every square is a rhombus, but not every rectangle is a square. Not every rhombus is a square. So just kind of think about that, and if you need help, let me know. What's the best name for this polygon? If it wants the best, then there's only going to be one answer. And it has to, and you're going to look at, let me do something real quick because I know the answer to this one. Okay, I think I've kind of covered that. Okay, so for this question, it has four sides. Okay? Let me do one more thing. I was going to do it. We'll go. The more specific information you have, the smaller the answer is going to get. Like if you know that you have 90 degrees, then you know you have a rectangle. But you don't know that you have a square and stuff like that. So it's just going to kind of look at all of this at one time. You have a quadrilateral because there's four sides. And on that four sides, opposite sides are congruent, which makes it a parallelogram. But more specifically, those opposite sides are congruent to everything else. So it's not just a parallelogram. It is a rhombus. It's not a trapezoid because all opposite sides are the same. It's not a rectangle because you don't have 90 degree angles. It's not a trapezoid. And it's not a rhombus. A rhombus has all sides the same length. So it's either going to be a rectangle or a parallelogram. It looks like a rectangle, but you cannot guess that it's a rectangle.
if it does not give you the information, you cannot assume that these are right angles right there. So because I can't assume it, then it's not a rectangle. It is just a parallelogram. Like on this one. It tells you that the angles are 90 degrees. If the angles are 90 degrees, then it's either going to be a rectangle or it's going to be a square. Okay? Now, to be a square, all sides have to be the same. Do you know that all sides are the same? No, you do not know that all sides are the same, so it's going to be a rectangle. What name best describes this polygon? The only thing you know is that it's four-sided and one pair of parallel sides, so it's a trapezoid. The only thing you know about this is it's four sides. You do not have any other information, so it is a quadrilateral. Okay? Now, these are the same, and these are the same. If it was a parallelogram, then whenever they're the same, they would be away from each other, across from each other, opposite each other. On this, they are next to each other, which it means adjacent. And it's a kite. We all know what a kite looks like. Wow, there's a lot going on here. We have four right angles. We have all sides being the same. So it's a square. Which terms? Choose all that apply. It's not a rhombus because not all sides are the same. It is not a parallelogram because opposite sides are not parallel. Both opposite sides are not parallel. It is not a rectangle because we do not have right angles. The only thing it is an isosceles trapezoid. The reason why it's isosceles is because those are the same.